Subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get latest updates from learnfordafer.com.
You have variety of dresses in your cupboard. Have you ever thought about from where these clothes come? Or more specifically, how these clothes are made? Dear students, the clothes are made of fabrics, and fabrics are made from fibers. A fiber is basically a string made of some material.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on LearnFutaFut Android app. Download the app now.
Have you ever tried to thread a needle? Sometimes, the end of the thread is separated into few thin strands. These thin strands are fibers. On the basis of source, fibers are of two types: natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Natural fibers are obtained from plants or animals. For example, cotton is obtained from plants, wool is obtained from fleece of sheep, hair of rabbit and yak. The cocoon of silkworm gives us silk fiber. Technological innovations and chemical treatments made it possible to construct fibers artificially. Such fibers are called artificial fibers or synthetic fibers or man-made fibers. For example, rayon, nylon, polyester and acrylic.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on LearnFutaFut Android app. Download the app now.
We obtain plant fibers from plants such as cotton, jute, hemp, flax, etc. In this video, we will understand more about cotton and jute fibers. Cotton fibers are obtained from cotton plants. Cotton plants are grown in the fields having black soil. It needs warm climate for its growth.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on LearnFutaFut Android app. Download the app now.
It is grown in Punjab, Haryana, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh states of India. A cotton plant is small or middle-sized woody body. It is categorized as shrub or bush. During flowering, the cotton plants produce flowers of yellowish-white color. After few days, these flowers turn pink-red. Slowly, flowers change into green cotton balls. A grown cotton ball is similar in size of that of lemon. After maturity, these balls burst open and we see soft, fluffy white cotton with seeds covered in it. Cotton and cotton ball can contain about 5 lakh cotton fibers. If you look at the field with white cotton, it looks as if field is covered with snow. Cotton is picked from the balls with hand. The seeds are separated from fibers by combing. This process is called ginning of the cotton. Previously, ginning was done by hands. However, these days, well-developed machines make the work easy. This is how we get cotton fiber. Cotton fibers are used for making clothes, the most soft and breathable textile. The word textile means flexible material made from fibers. Cotton is also used for filling mattresses, quilts or pillows.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on LearnFutaFut Android app. Download the app now.
Jute fiber is a soft and long natural fiber. As it have golden and silky shine, therefore it is also called golden fiber. It is obtained from jute plant. Jute plants are grown mainly in the fields of West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. It is cultivated in rainy season. The jute plants are harvested at the flowering stage. Jute fibers are obtained from outer skin of jute plants called ribbon. Fibers are also obtained from the stem of jute plants. Stem of jute plants are bundled and kept in soft running water for few days. During this time, the fibers become loose from the stem and can be easily separated. The process of extraction of jute fiber from the stem is called retting. There are many uses of jute fiber. It is also used for making sacks and coarse cloth. We are also making curtains, chair coverings, area rugs, hessian cloths, etc.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Futafut Android app. Download the app now.
We have variety of things made of cotton. For example, clothes, bed sheets, towels, fishing nets, tents, etc. In order to make these things, we cannot use cotton fibers directly. It is because they does not have required length and strength. We need to convert cotton fibers into yarn. The process of making yarn from cotton fibers is called spinning.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Futafut Android app. Download the app now.
You can do it at your home as well. Here is a method. Take some cotton and remove seeds from it. With one hand, pull some fibers from the cotton and twist them continuously. By doing so, fibers come close to each other. They hold each other tightly and we get a long string. The long and strong string obtained by twisting fibers together is cotton yarn. Fabric is made from yarn. We get variety of fabric based on amount of twist in the yarn. For example, low twist makes soft, bulky and velvety fabric, while very high twist makes silky, shiny fabric. In general, average twist is used to make most common fabrics. A simple device used for making yarn is hand spindle. It is also called darkli. A famous hand operated device is charkha. Mahatma Gandhi popularized it during independence movement. Nowadays, spinning machines are used to produce yarn on large quantity. These machines produce yarn with good quality.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Futafut Android app. Download the app now.
After making yarn from the cotton, it is then processed to make fabric. There are variety of methods for making fabric from yarn. In this lesson, we will learn about weaving. Let's understand it with an activity. Take sufficiently big square pieces of paper, one red and other blue.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Futafut Android app. Download the app now.
Make equal strips of red paper. Take blue paper and fold it in the middle. From the folded side, cut the paper at equal distances, but not all the way through. Now unfold the paper and you will see the paper with cut in it. Now take a strip of red paper and put it inside the paper such that it is under the first blue strip and over the next. Now take the second red strip and weave it such that it is under the first blue strip and over the next. Repeat this process few times. Now you should see this pattern. You can weave yarn in the same way, but for that, we need two sets of yarn. The process of arranging two sets of yarn to make fabric is called weaving. It is very difficult to weave yarn with hands. To make it simple, we use a loom. Basically, a loom is a structure which is used to give support to your weave. A tightly held thread or yarn strung over the loom vertically is the wrap thread or wrap yarn. another thread which is drawn through and inserted over and under the wrap thread is the weft thread or weft yarn. With weft thread, it is possible to create different patterns and designs in the weave and therefore different designs in the fabric. In handlooms, weft thread is inserted by hands. However, use of machines helps us to make the process faster.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Futafut Android app. Download the app now.
Your grandmother must have made sweaters for you. It is also a fabric. Do you know how it is made? If you ask her, she will tell you that a single thread is turned into fabric. The process of converting a single thread into fabric is called knitting. In this process, a single continuous thread is used to form loops and interlocks them with the help of knitting needles.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Futafut Android app. Download the app now.
It is done either by hands or by machines. The series of loops so formed are called stitches. The vertical columns of interconnected loops are called veils and horizontal rows of interconnected loops are called courses. In veils or courses, the yarn follows circuitous mandering path. A very important property of knitted fabric is that it is stretchable. With this property, we are able to produce things such as sweaters, socks, t-shirts, gloves, blankets, as well as close-fitting garments. On wearing, the loop structure stretches and takes the body shape, giving tight fitting.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Futafut Android app. Download the app now.
Today we have variety of clothes. We wear different clothes in different season. Our ancestors does not have all of these clothes. In ancient times, people used big leaves of trees, animal skin or animal furs to cover themselves as well as to have protection from heat, cold and rain. During the time, they started farming. They learned to weave twigs and grass so as to form mats and baskets. They learned to twist hairs obtained from animal body so as to form long strands. These strands were woven to form fabrics. People made similar strings from cotton and made fabrics from it. They also obtained natural fibers from flax and made fabric from it. Invention of machines increased the speed of making fabric. These machines produce fine quality of fabric. In earlier days, people used to wrap the fabric around their body. Later, sewing needles were invented with which stitching fabric into clothes was started. The method and tools of stitching were improved over a time. The stitched cloth gained popularity and thus different fashions came into existence. Even though there are variety of stitched clothes available today, but the popularity of unstitched fabric, for example, sari, dhoti, lungi or turban remain the same. I hope you have understood this video very well. Thanks for watching this video. Get your favorite course now and experience better understanding of concepts within short time only on learnfatafat.com.
Watch ad-free and complete syllabus on Learn Futafut Android app. Download the app now. Like, share and subscribe learnfutafut.com and press the bell icon to never miss an updates from learnfutafut.com.